Welcome back to Pfeiffer Vacuum. In the last video, I talked about the fundamentals of vacuum technology. The final pressure of a vacuum system depends on several factors of the whole vacuum system. And today I would like to talk about the requirements of a chamber and the components for your application in the UHV range. Let us start with the chamber. You can have a look at the chamber on my right-hand side, which is made of stainless steel. Stainless steel has some good properties, which makes it to the ideal material for applications in the UHV range, but for sure you also have to treat the surface right, for example, that the outgas rate is very low. The chamber on my right-hand side has also several flanges. You can, for example, connect viewports, gauges to measure the pressure, or, as you can see here, the pumping system. Now let's have a look at the components. Before you connect the components or gauges to the chamber, be sure everything is clean and dry. Therefore, it is important always to wear grease-free gloves if you handle these materials. And before you start, you should also clean the surface with lint-free wipes and an alcohol. In this case here, we have a CF flange. Therefore, you should use metal sealings like this copper ring. This copper ring is already used. If you want to connect the gauge and the chamber, use a new copper ring. If you want to reach pressures below 1 to the power of minus 8 hectopascal, you should always use metal sealings. Here we have an O-ring with an elastomer sealing, and these elastomer sealings are not suitable for pressure ranges below 1 to the power of minus 8 hectopascal due to the permeation of the elastomer material. But if you are working in the backing pressure regime, then you can use these materials. For example, if we want now to connect the backing pump and the turbo pump. Now I will connect this ISOKF component and the backing pump. Today I talked about chambers, materials and components. There are different types of flanges to connect the components and the chamber. Here, for example, we have a CF flange with a metal sealing. In the backing pressure regime, you can also use elastomer sealings like the ISOKF materials. In any case, be sure that your components and materials are dry and clean. That's why you should always wear grease-free gloves to prevent the system from new contaminations. Now I can connect the backing pump and the turbo pump, for example, with this pipe. It is flexible. And then we can start the pumping system. And in my next video, I want to talk about the backing pump. So stay tuned and see you soon. And if you enjoyed watching this video, please don't forget to like and subscribe.